I don't know why I sat down, because I gotta get back up. But what's up, Danny? I'm YouTube, and I'm doing things a little differently this time. I recorded this video 3 times already, and I'm not gonna record it again. So I gotta stop stuttering, because this video is getting uploaded. But instead of showcasing everything at once, like I was before, I'm gonna showcase everything one step at a time and give it a more detailed look. So I don't know if you could tell by the Swiss cheese box already, but this is one of the only times you want your Jordan box to say Flight on it. These are the off-white Jordan 4s in the sale colorway. Relay's probably washing that shit out, but I'll put a picture of it. Wrapping paper just says off-white with the Jordan Jumpman symbol on it. Nothing special about that. But right here, people are calling this shit Sneaker of the Year. I know people say that shit a lot whenever a new sneaker comes out. But personally, I think it's not Sneaker of the Year. The Quantum Yeezys will be the one for me, always. Rollout was crazy. Like I said, I've been waiting for that sneaker for over 4 years. But like I said, this is the best off-white Jordan collaboration period. Not George's Jordan, this is the best one. I know everyone is a fan of the OG Prestos, but personally, these are better than them. I love the fact that Virgil decided to step away from doing another Jordan 1, even though those canary yellows are beautiful. But I think we all need a different sneaker model. And Jordan 4s are beautiful. Who doesn't love a pair? Sale hangman to match the shoe. Nice and beautiful. Please don't wear your sneaker with this shit. Take this shit off, guys. Even though I know most of you guys buy these shoes, wear them once, and then sell them. And then the Ziploc to match the sneaker as well. That is gonna focus, but the Ziploc just says off-white on that shit, whatever. I'll put a picture up. Don't wear this shit with the Ziploc either, no matter what off-white we're wearing. These shoes are loud enough for us to know that they're off-white, especially with those fucking Kygers. They drag on the floor and that looks disgusting. Quotation marks, said Air. The soles on these shits are beautiful. Nice little mint colorway on them. Same thing on the Nike symbol. Yeah, they look extremely nice. They even come with laces that match the soles. Yikes. So we have like an eggshell white right here. Thought it's gonna focus, but it's whatever. No fucking way. We got a black. And then we got the mint colorway. These will look so beautiful with those Europe exclusives Jordan 1s that came out, but I can't afford those because I'm broke. But off-white laces resell. They're both like $45 in the aftermarket. Sorry guys, let me give you guys more detailed shots. That's the tongue. Usually, like on the side of the sneaker, it would say like the Nike Oregon stuff and the off-white shit, but it's there on the inside. It's not noticeable. Throughout the sneaker, hopefully the camera picks it up, there's fraying all around. And I'm really curious how the shoes is gonna age. How it's gonna yellow, first of all, I wanna see if it's gonna yellow and beautifully or terribly. I think they're gonna yellow terribly, but the fraying should be interesting. The material on the toe box is the same material that's on the toe box of the off-white Jordan 5. So that's something nice. Stars in this shit, obviously. Nice and clean. Jordan 4s are definitely like one of the best Jordans to ever be made. And I don't really know what else to say about the sneaker because people have been doing reviews for them for over a month. People like Seth Fowler and shit run YouTube when it comes to sneakers. So shout out to them. I did not show you guys the translucent Nike symbol, even though I probably post pictures up. Relay's definitely washing that shit out, but that shit looks beautiful, man. So do my fucking nails. Wow, look at me. What a boss. There's a rumored red colorway releasing on these, but I think these look way better. Like I said, these are one of the best. One of the best off-white shoes to release. Even though the red colorway is nice, I'll put pictures of those up on the screen. Nothing else to really say about the sneaker other than I got them off Nike Sneakers for $200. Yeah, I know everyone hates that fucking ad break, but everyone has been saying since before the release that these are women's sizing, and I still got them in a size 10 because I don't know, it was the morning. I guess I was fucking drunk or something. but I bought them in a women's 10, forgetting that they're women's sizing. So now I need a women's 11 and a half. This woman's 10 is reselling for about, I sold it for $950. It's going for about $1,000 in the aftermarket. I did not sell them on StockX. Fuck that app. They still owe me payouts from over a month ago. But yeah, my size, my 11 and a half in women's, which equates to a 10 in men, it's going for around $1,200. I'm just gonna pay the difference to get them, because I was the only one out of my friend group to get them. And like I said before, if I'm the only one in my friend group to get a sneaker, I'm gonna keep them, because that just means they're extra rare. But since it's women's sizing, it's the higher up you get, like the bigger the size, the more rare it is, or the more expensive it is in the aftermarket, because they know that guys are just buying them. And damn, I was gonna say one more thing. Oh my God, remember what I was gonna say. All right, one reason that everyone was so mad about this release is because the Alphar website sucks. COVID made every single store closed, so there was only like one in-store raffle and I was empty gallery. Usually I win those raffles, but I didn't with this release. Like I said before, I won them on Nike sneakers, but everyone dislikes Nike sneakers because they think it's botted. A portion of that is true, but a portion of that is not true. Like, people bought Nike sneakers, but not all bots are successful because Nike finds a way to stop most of them. People have to understand is that there's millions of people trying for a sneaker that has like 27,000 stock or whatever. I just guessed, I threw that number out there. I don't know the stock. But I appreciate bots. If there's like ATCs, if people are running auto checkouts or slots, I usually buy them. Because like I said, I respect bots. I'm too dumb to try to run them myself, and I also have a Mac, so like most bots aren't even compatible. But bots stop like these people that cannot dress from getting nice sneakers like this and ruining them, wearing them with fucking H&M and PacSun jeans or Fear God Essentials. That's what bots stop. So if you guys want to buy shoes like this and break your outfit, just pay the resale market. And if not, there will be another sneaker that you would want. It's the way life goes. But shout out to my friend Andrew. He said I would win these on Nike sneakers. He wished it upon me, or he spoke it into existence. Shout out to you, bro. Love you. Hopefully I can cut this video nice, because I literally sat here for like 3 minutes because I forgot what I was going to say about the bots. Like I said, let me know what you guys think. If you guys made it this far, please like, comment, and subscribe. I'm 11 subs away from 300. It means absolutely nothing to me to hit that shit, because I do YouTube for fun, but I would appreciate it, I guess. Peace out.